Rex Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Marianne Mobley, Paul Williams, and Marcia Wallace as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Rivers.
Okay, thank you, John. Hello, friends.
How do you do?
Hi, dear.
How do you do?
Welcome to you, one and all. I don't have my breath spritzer. Do you have one, John? Have you got one?
I happen to have one.
Good.
Funny, you should ask.
Thank you very much.
$9.
No.
We don't have any new people on the show,
yes,
so you're not...
Yes, we do have a new person. I always welcome the new people with a nice, warm, friendly kiss.
I knew you'd go funny in your old age.
But in your case, I think I'll pass.
That's right.
Thank you, Paul. You're
welcome.
We really book big stars on this show, don't we? Now, the people in the studio audience have shown you. They know how big you are, but... I mean, Richard, what seat do you want to seat in? Hey, what seat you want? Hey, Jen.
Is it comfortable there? Everything all right?
No.
The short kid wants equal time, down there.
Equal time over here. Yeah. Who wants equal time?
The short kid.
Lovely young man.
Come with me. Follow me, Richard.
Richard is a friend of mine.
Come over here. Come here, William. Richard.
Yeah.
You know Paul Williams. Have you ever worked with him before?
We know each other.
You know each other.
We're friends through Bill Bixby.
Right.
True?
Right. But nobody's perfect. All kidding aside, how tall are you?
7'2".
Found him.
5'11".
Yeah.
I'm so sick of the height nonsense. Yeah. I'll never do another short joke as long as I live.
You're a parrot in red.
How tall are you?
How tall was I?
Before you passed away, Gene, you look so lifelike, too, honey.
Yes, I'm.
You know, it'd be wonderful
job.
If
what?
They both could go into a clothing store with on-the-rack clothes and just give the guy a craziness. Wouldn't that be funny?
Right.
Oh,
I would love to see
or
that.
Or he would walk into those, one of those Adler elevator shoe stores and say, I want to be taller than my girl. Send me a pair. You're wearing Adler elevators.
I buy my clothes in Hong Kong at a big man's store. Didn't even hear it, you know.
All right.
Someday I'll have my own show and you'll hear all these lines.
Oh, I'm sorry, did I interrupt something?
I said that in Hong Kong I shop at a big man's store.
Oh, you do? Hey!
Thank you, Jim.
You're right. When they hear them, it works better.
This is very self-indulgent of me. You're a patient audience, and I won't do it again.
All right. Now let's welcome Tony Menendi and Elaine Nesworski. Applause. Welcome to the both of you. We want to find out who you are and where you're from. Tony, please tell us a little bit about yourself.
I'm a Los Angeles police officer. I'm working Venice Beach area. I live out in Newhall. I'm married. And for relaxation, I play ice hockey.
Where do you play that?
Culver City and Canal Valley.
They have rinks?
Yes.
That's a nice place to go on a hot day here in California.
Very nice. It's the only place to go.
Right. All right, Tony, good luck to you. Elaine, tell us about yourself, please.
I'm a part-time housewife, student, bookkeeper. I'm part-time everything.
Really?
I mean...
Well, we'll talk about it after the show, my dear. I don't want you to reveal any more now.
Good.
All right. Good luck to both of you. Tony, you have a choice of A or B.
B, please.
Tony says he wants B, and this is what it says. Rita said, my husband is a junk food junkie. Today, he wanted to know which wine goes best with blank. It's a good one.
With blank?
Sure.
Close enough. Here it is. Rita said, my husband is a junk food junkie. Today, he wanted to know which wine goes best with blanks.
Twinkies.
Twinkies! Very good. Thank you. Thanks a lot, Sid. I'll get that fly. Twinkies is the answer. All right, Richard, this is your first time at bat. What answer have you got for us? Don't touch it until I tell you to.
Hit him.
Oh, don't.
Well, wine and Twinkies is great, but I like wine and jelly beans.
Wine and jelly beans.
It's good.
Have you Call seen everything. How tall he is?
You want him to stand up again? And walk among you?
Who gave All him right. the prop? Who gave the host the prop? We must never give him prop.
Hit my fly and you'll never walk again.
Flies carry disease. If that fly...
That's the rumor around town, huh?
Yes,
that flies
right.
carry disease.
Okay, Brett.
Walked right into it, didn't you? Okay, I said a Big Mac with everything, plus ketchup, a side of fries, and chocolate malted.
All right.
Now watch it. That's a fabulous answer, and he's a very good friend of mine.
Twinkies was an excellent response, I thought.
You see, when you're not tall or short or something dynamic, you have to wear a hat to catch people's attention.
That's true.
I said a quarter pounder Big Mac.
All right. Tony, I like yours best so far. Nothing personal, Stars, but Tony really came up with a wonderful answer because it would be ludicrous to drink wine with Twinkies.
Blue Nun is good with everything.
All right.
Something else that would be ludicrous. And when you mention junk food, I immediately think of a Snickers bar.
A Snickers bar. All right.
Gotta be chocolate.
Yes.
But a Snickers, you always have a Heineken's with. I know that. Anybody who's been around the world senses that. When you talk about junk food, you're talking grease. When you're talking grease, you're talking French fries.
French fries. All right, that is the ultimate junk
what do you
food,
mean,
I guess.
Boo? It's an intelligent answer.
Don't pay any attention to them, Paul.
Right. Yes, ma'am.
I'm not particularly tall or short or certifiable today. I just have the right answer.
Twinkie! Did that bring joy to your heart, that warm applause?
Of course it did. They've always loved me.
Oh. I must tell you, can I interject one thought?
You may interject a thought.
I don't want to blow your career because I hear the kind of humor
you're
doing.
Oh, no, I'm out of show.
Give me a moment here.
Okay.
From the angle that I'm sitting, she is much more shapely than the things she says. You often look.
Oh.
Yeah, so don't put yourself down anymore in that respect. Sit down, you animal. All right, here
Still
it is.
My heart.
Fred said, my wife is the world's worst housekeeper. How worse was she? What kind of talk is that? Got to pay attention to grammar here. We're always careful with grammar. My wife is the world's worst housekeeper. Today, not only did she sweep the dirt under the rug, she swept the blank under the rug. Elaine. Fred said, my wife is the world's worst housekeeper. Today, not only did she sweep the dirt under the rug, she swept the blank under the rug.
Dirty clothes.
Aww. Dirty clothes.
Well, it's time to go.
So hang around. You got to play two games.
All right.
And you may get lucky in the second one. But not in this one. All right, Richard, sir. Sir Richard.
Yes, well, I have four children, and the oldest one is 5 and a half.
Yeah.
And I've never done this, but I think she swept the kids under the
house. Swept the kids under the house. That's a good answer.
Okay. No. What is a very good thing? You say she's a problem of doing them, the breakfast dishes.
Breakfast dishes.
What? Well, you people.
I will not have all that booing going on.
So
I don't want to write an answer that gets booed, so I didn't write what she said. I didn't write breakfast. I just wrote dishes.
Dishes. All right. My wife is the world's worst housekeeper. She not only swept the dirt under the rug, she swept the blank under the rug. And Elaine said dirty clothes.
Sorry, Elaine, but when she got started, she even swept the baby under
the
rug.
The baby under the rug. Good. All right.
Well, any decent American knows that you can't go around sweeping our kids under the rug, but it's fun to do it to your dog.
There we
your John, baby.
All right. Marcia.
Jean.
Oh, Marcia.
I don't do accents either, hon, or impressions. And this time I have the wrong answer.
The dog.
The dog.
All right, so you got two dogs here.
Dog,
one to nothing in Tony's favor.
Oh, there.
Shall we carry on here and go to round two? Here we go. Tony, you're ahead 1-0, so you go first.
B again, please, Jean.
B it is. All right. Jane said it isn't easy being married to an airline pilot. He even takes his showers with a blank. Jane says, it isn't easy being married to an airline pilot. He even takes his showers with a blank.
Co-pilot.
Co-pilot.
I guess you've heard about those two, haven't you?
Yeah, I almost said biplane, but...
Biplane.
Yeah.
Thank you,
right.
Very kinky.
But I didn't think anybody would go for a co-pilot, but 747.
He takes his showers with a 747.
Yeah, it's a big shower.
It would be very difficult.
Well, that's what I do.
Oh, you do?
Yeah.
Oh, well, that's it. You must have a big shower.
Big
All right.
men need big showers, baby.
Right.
You get my meaning?
Yes.
No, there was nothing wrong. This man was as heterosexual as they come. Took him with the stewardess.
Uh-huh.
Pat.
Hello.
He wasn't that heterosexual.
Oh, really?
Because he knew a priest once who turned out to be a stewardess.
Uh-huh. Send your mail directly to Charles Nelson Riley.
Oh, it was in the paper the other day. Just read the paper. Don't look at me or attack me. It's in the paper.
Okay. Mary Ann.
Yes, sir.
Jane, so isn't easy being married to an airline pilot. He even takes his showers with a...
Well, I thought it might be interesting if it was with the stewardess.
Really?
There's some very pretty stewardesses.
There are. Wonderful stewardess.
Very helpful?
Yes.
I'll tell you from experience that it's wonderful to take a shower with a stewardess.
Would you like
kinky.
To confess everything? You want to go into details? I mean, we can get the, that...
No, I never camera. Really took a shower with a stewardess. I always wanted to. God,
all right, don't cry.
I don't like to.
No, we'll find a stewardess
for you. Stewardess.
No, we'll find a stewardess.
Your stewardess, call me.
All right, here we go. Are you ready?
Yep.
All right. Tough Tony is so tough.
Yeah.
In high school biology class, he used to dissect frogs with his blank. That's how tough he was. Elaine, tough Tony is so tough. In high school biology class, he used to dissect frogs with his blank.
His hands.
His hands.
Ah, oh, what is...
What would you
Wait
say?
Teeth.
Teeth.
Pinky.
Weirdos. They're weirdos, Richard.
Yeah, they are.
No matter what you say, you're going to be wrong.
I know, but they're my kind of people.
All right. Have
tough,
a go at it.
Tough Tony was so tough, he dissected frogs with his friend Kermit, and he did it with his teeth.
Teeth.
They're your kind of people.
You got it. Right. Kermit the Frog and the Wendy. Yes.
Am I the villainessa here? No, I'm not. Oh, okay. No, no. I didn't say. What did she say?
She said hands.
Hands. No,
she
I didn't
hands.
Say that. I said shiv, spelled S-C-H-I-V.
Shiv.
Which is a
knife.
A knife, which he also used on his schoolmate.
Uh-huh. All right.
Boy, I mean, it's not good, but I wasn't too crazy about the question. I don't like this booing. I have to say that.
They don't care, Brett.
You watch it, man.
Oh. She turned on us.
Can I jump in here and keep the game going?
Razor.
All right.
Thank you.
Elaine is looking for a pair of hands, Mary Ann.
Aren't we all?
You had my offer earlier. And you rejected it out of hand.
Oh, no, she didn't.
Oh.
Oh, no, she didn't. Well, you didn't like the original answer, and you may not like this one, but it might match. I said his fingernails.
Fingernails. Oh, it does match. All right.
Yeah, I mean, this is a... The Dental Association will love this. I'm sorry, guys. I went with teeth like the kinky audience.
Teeth. Says teeth up there. All right. Teeth is an excellent response, I think. Yes.
Little human interest here, huh?
Yes, right.
Did you know that the short kid here is going to be getting the Man of the Year award from the Police and Sheriff's
California Order of Police? I'm getting the cops this year. The California
That's
Organization of Police and Sheriffs. I have
you.
Always been a great friend to law enforcement.
Man of the Year.
Nice.
Congratulations.
There is not nearly enough recognition for both the police and the fire department. That's it.
They
Those
do.
Are my heroes.
They're a wonderful bunch.
They're a one. I just wanted to give you a tip of the gnome hat to Tony for being a cop.
All right.
Marcia has not shown her answer.
That's right.
Oh, do we want Marcia's answer?
Try to keep up with the show, would you?
All right.
Gene.
Gene, your attention span is in the minus column.
Well,
all right, now read my lips.
Yes.
My answer is, and they're going to love it, but I don't want to be associated with this group at all. It's teeth.
Teeth. So there we are at the end of this game, which ends in a tie, 1-1. That means we'll have to go to a tiebreaker, and we'll do that right after this.
William, 7 feet, 2 inches tall there.
Now, we go to a tiebreaker, one question for each. The one who matches the most will be the winner. Tony, A or B?
B, please.
All right, here we go. Dirty Dave never washes his hands, and in this profession, that's horrible because Dirty Dave is a blank. All right, Tony, we're all set for you. Dirty Dave never washes his hands, and in this profession, that's horrible because Dirty Dave is a blank.
Dentist.
A dentist.
Yeah.
Blah. Revolting, isn't it?
Yes. I was thinking of a doctor, too, but I wanted to be one, but I couldn't with these hands, so I figured I'd better go for a cook.
A cook. All right. What do you say?
I tell you, the fool ever thought the fuzz would get too smart for the room. He's come up with some terrific answers.
Excellent.
I said doctor.
Doctor.
What?
You could be a dentist for Big Mouth. Doctor.
There are two doctors there.
And
one cook. And Marianne, what have you got? Dirty Dave, one that never washes his hands, and that's horrible because Dirty Dave is a...
Well, I thought, what could be the worst thing?
Yeah.
In my mind, it's a surgeon.
A surgeon who never scrubs.
You're not quite sure, are you?
Paul?
Dirty Dave is a housewife. No, that's not what I... Well, weird person Dirty Dave is. I'm a doctor like everybody else did. I'm sorry.
Doctor. Dentist is what,
I march to my own drum, Gene, as
you march to your own drum.
That's right. It's too bad Tony's married because we really should go pick up furniture. Dentist.
There it is. That's true. All right. Elaine? Here we go. Ugly Ulfria has a head start on everyone for St. Patrick's Day. She already has green blank. Have you stopped growing?
No.
All right, Elaine. Ugly Ulfria has a head start on everyone for St. Patrick's Day. She already has green blank.
Hair.
Green hair. Green hair, she says. Richard, what do you say?
That's really a ridiculous answer.
Ridiculous.
Yeah. That's what I said, too.
Hair it is. One for her.
No, no, I'm sorry. You knew that she was Irish by the green mold on her teeth?
Green mold on her teeth.
Mine is in the dressing room in the drawer. I said hair.
Ah. All right, Lane wins again, there. Broke the tie. Congratulations to you. Come on down here and take your place on the little blue dot. Right over there. There. Get over there, there. We'll see you later. Okay, Tony? Okay. Game two coming up later for Tony Menendi. Now we have this coming up for you.
Monday returns next Monday night at 8 Eastern only on Game Show Network.
Gene Rabernier, join us next time for Match Game. Thank you all. Goodbye.
Some contestants will receive from Kinney a great selection of great American shoe styles. Kinney's got the look you want, America. That's why Kinney is a great American shoe store. And Bola Beauty Real Rose is specially treated to keep their natural beauty for years. The ideal gift anytime at florists and better stores now. And Good Air CA90 Ecologizer, recirculating air cleaner, deodorizer, removes tobacco smoke, odors, dust, pollen continuously, keeps the air you breathe fresher, cleaner. And the Cherrywood collection from Echo. Kitchen tools with genuine Cherrywood handle, shaped for better grip and control, work as beautiful as they look. And it's Frey and O. Henry Delicious Penis, chewy caramel and fudge covered with chocolatey goodness. If you're wild about penis, you'll be nuts about O. Henry. And a baking dish and cream mess, the macaroni and spaghetti in a famous green box. Cooks up tender without sticking together. And a calculator and pledge gives your furniture a clean, clear, more beautiful shine. Pledge brings out the beauty every time you dust.
You talking to me? You talking to me? Because I'm the only one here.
Do I get the part?
You talking to me?
Whammy, coming up next, only on Game Show Network.
For Match Game, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. This program is edited for both.